620 million for COVID and about 315 million to a Lassa for the Lassa fever response. We're managing that on behalf of the country. A lot of these funds will go to supporting preparedness and response efforts at the states. So, but some of things have to be done centrally. So we've just got those funds. And right now we have a detailed incident action plan that is driving the disbursement of these funds and the use of it to prepare Nigerians for the event of a bigger outbreak. Okay. So we have a multi-stage approach to preventing spread in Nigeria. The first is obviously at the point of entry. You would have seen that we've put a lot of efforts, much more than many other countries are doing, to prevent cases from coming in. We also recognize that not everyone will come in with clinical symptoms, just like the first case. So we're really educating physicians around the country to be aware of this disease, to make the connection with where people have traveled from. Because it's with symptoms and a travel history, if you put those two together, you increase the likelihood of that. Then, in addition to that, we're spreading the news to all Nigerians. It's why I've been on media all the time. You know, we can't monitor everyone that travels in Nigeria, so we need people to understand that if they have traveled and they have symptoms, it's in their own best interest and their family's interest and the interest of their loved ones to let us know. So we have a toll-free number. You can get it from the NCDC website. You don't pay anything for calling. It's accessible 24/7. And therefore, we need the media to do a little bit more than what you do normally in reporting events. Because when you report an event between two football teams, it doesn't really matter who wins. But this time, it is existential for all of us that we win together.